To print images, they will have to be converted to CMYK colors. Let's first have a look at how to do this in Photoshop. I open an image that I downloaded from Pixabay. Photoshop tells me that the image doesn't have an embedded RGB profile. Photoshop doesn't know whether this image is in Pro Photo, Color Match, Apple RGB, Adobe 1998, or sRGB color image. So let's find out. Normally, when there is no profile attached to an image, and almost no downloaded image from the internet will have an attached profile, the image is sRGB. So let's see whether this image indeed is sRGB. The colors of the image look great. Below we see that we are viewing the image as an sRGB image. sRGB was created by Microsoft and HP in 1996. The goal of sRGB was the standardization of color for electric devices. sRGB stands for standard red, green, and blue. sRGB is the color space for web browsers and the industry standard for web content. So sRGB can more or less be seen as the world's default color space. So what are the other RGB color spaces that we saw when we opened the photo? These other RGB color spaces can show even more colors than sRGB. But to be able to see these extra colors, you also will need a special monitor that can show these colors. And these monitors are expensive. And not even standard monitors are all capable of showing all the colors of the standard sRGB color space. I am quite sure that this image is sRGB, but let's see what happens when we view this image inside another RGB color space. I go to Edit, Assign Profile. We get the same window that we had when we opened the image. But now, we can actually see what happens to the image when we change the RGB color model. Let's try Pro Photo RGB. This doesn't look good, so the image is definitely not Pro Photo. I will not go through them all, because I already know that all images from Pixabay are sRGB. Now that we have our image in the correct RGB color space, we are ready to convert it to CMYK. But also CMYK has different color spaces, also known as ICC profiles. So which one should we choose? The answer to this is the subject of the next lecture.